previous video, I introduced you to a new Excel function called the Lambda function. This is currently available in the beta channel, so make sure you check that video out before you watch this one, because you need to have an idea what a Lambda is before you get recursive with it. A recursive Lambda involves a process that's looped, that keeps repeating. Here's an example. We have a list of names and we have the skills of each person written in a single cell. Unfortunately, we have a lot of typos. Here, for example, we have SQL, SAP, Word, and PPT. The word PPT needs to be replaced with PowerPoint. The rest are fine. But for this one, where I have Office 365 and PowerPoint, I need to replace that with Microsoft 365 and PowerPoint written together. If I've already written my recursive Lambda, all I have to do is type in equals, then the name I've given the Lambdas, in this case I've called it Mega Replace, and the arguments my Lambda needs, which is the cell that needs changing, the start of the before column, and then the after column. I press enter, and it all updates automatically. It's like magic. The way it works is that this Lambda calls itself over and over again and executes a process. The process in this case is to substitute the value of before with after. And it does this one cell at a time. Every time it does a replacement, it changes its own state, basically its own text. With this new state, it moves on to the next row to check. In Excel, if you have a formula that references itself, you end up with a circular reference. With recursive lambdas, you overcome this as long as you have a point of exit. So you have to have a rule where that lambda is going to get out of your lambda. Writing recursive lambdas can be quite challenging because they're not easy to test or debug. You're creating something that's referencing itself. So it's kind of like the chicken and the egg. You have to create both successfully at the same time. So let me share my approach with you. Since the purpose of a Lambda is to create a function that we can reuse, we first have to think of what this core function could be. And it helps to think one cell at a time. So let's say we only had this skill. We want it to look for this text here that's in before. If it's included in the skill, I want to replace it with after. What function can I use to get this done? Well, I can use the substitute function. Substitute has three required arguments. The text, so that's my starting text, then the old text that I want to look for, which is this one, and the new text that I want to replace it with, which is this one. Now, what am I going to get when I press enter? I'm going to get the same thing back because MS Excel is not found within this text. Now, a recursive Lambda can work like this. I'm going to take now this as my starting point. So I'm going to go back to the substitute function. My text is this one. Old text is the next one in line and new text is this. Now, when I close bracket and press enter, what am I going to get? PowerPoint is going to get corrected. What happens next? Well, the latest state of this function is this right now. So this is going to become my text. My old text is the next one. New text is this. What's going to happen? Nothing. I'm going to end up with the state I had before where PowerPoint has been corrected. Now, when I get to the next instance, this is going to be my new state. Old text is this, new text is this. What am I going to get? Office 365 will be replaced with Microsoft 365. This is how a recursive Lambda behaves. You can make it go through a list. So the first thing you need when you create such a Lambda is first, what's your core function? Well, here I can use the substitute function. Next is to figure out how many parameters do I need. Well, all I have to do for that is take a look at my cell references. How many different cell references do I have? Three. So I probably need three parameters. Now, the last thing to think about is when are you going to leave that loop? So what's going to make it get out of the function? You have to have an exit strategy. And that can be different things. So it just depends what you come up with depending on your data set. In this case, one option can be whenever I come across a cell that's empty, I need to get out of the lambda. That's one option. So it loops through all of these. It comes across an empty cell, it's going to leave the function. If you don't plan this exit, your function is not going to work. Okay, so now that we have the basis of our lambda, let's write it down here. Let's start off with lambda, parameter or calculation. So remember, I used the substitute function, and substitute had three required parameters. Those are going to be my parameters. The first one is the text I want to replace. I'm going to use a T for that. The second parameter is the before, so I'm going to use a B. And then after, I'll use an A. These are my three parameters. Now comes the calculation. So I'm just going to press Alt Enter and continue down here. Let's start with the exit strategy. I'll use an if. My identifier in this case, I'm going to go with B. So if the B, which is my before cell here, is empty, it should leave the lambda. So I'm going to say if B equals nothing, then what do I want back? I want the latest state of T. Just like before we saw with the substitute function, I want that latest text, the latest state. So I want T back. Otherwise, what do I want back? Well, otherwise, I needed to put that latest status of T inside the function again. But it needs to revise B and A because it needs to move down one cell. Well, here's how things can get complicated. I need to think of a name that I'm going to give that final lambda, and I'm going to use that name here. So I'll call my final function mega replace. Now I'm referencing mega replace inside the function. Now I haven't created any names yet, but we're going to create it later on. This is what makes it difficult because you have to picture what the end result is. You can't really test it directly here. Now my function mega replace, which is the name of this lambda, needs three arguments. So whatever I do inside here, I need to have three arguments. The first one is my text. What is that going to be? Well, it's going to be this, but this is where I can stick my formula. It's going to be the substitute of T. Old text is B, the before, and the new text is A, the after. That's going to be my T. Now, next is B. What is that going to be? Well, first it's going to be here, and then it should go one down, and then one down, and so on. So one function I can use here is the offset function. My reference is B, is the before. So remember, when you're writing your lambda, you're creating a machine. You don't do cell references. You work with these variables. Each of them represents a cell reference. So just imagine that your cell reference is here. So that's going to be my B. And then the offset function requires how many rows I want to go down. Well, I want to go one row at a time. How many columns I want to move? I don't want to move at all, zero. Height and width are one. These are by default one, so I can close the bracket here. If I move B down by one, I also have to move A, so the after down, by one as well. So I'm going to go with offset A, one, zero. The mega replace function needs three arguments. That's the first one, this is the second one, and this is the last one. Now I can close the mega replace function here and then close the if function and close my lambda. Now when I press enter, of course it's not going to work because there is no mega replace function yet. I actually have to create it. I have to give it a name. Let's quickly do that. Let's just copy this, go to formulas, name manager, add a new name. I'm going to paste the formula here and call it mega replace. So here you have to be careful. You have to give it the same name as the one I gave it here. And if you ever want to move around inside the name manager box here, press F2 before you move with your arrow keys, because otherwise it's going to mess things up. Now, as a comment, you can write what T is, what B is, and what A is. So T is our text, B is before, and A is after. Now, it would have been great if we had a choice to get the help of Excel that tells us what each of the arguments is for when we're writing the function. But unfortunately, we don't get that. We have to remember what arguments are required and in which order. This is our mega replace function. Let's close this and now let's test it out. So I'm going to remove it from here. Go to the side here. Now is the big moment. So one reminder for you, take a look to see if you're subscribed to this channel. If you aren't, consider subscribing. Now let's see what is our first argument. That was this one, that's our text. And notice it uses structured referencing because this is an official Excel table. So the moment I'm going to press enter, it's going to copy the formula all the way down. Next was before, and that's going to be the first cell where I have the name. Now, of course, you can program this differently, so you can start from the header instead of there. I just did it this way. Now I'm going to fix this reference with an F4 because I always want my starting point to be here. The function is recursive. It's going to loop through these. My after is this one. Let's fix it as well with an A4, close bracket, press enter, and let's see if our function works. Office 365 PowerPoint was successfully replaced. Power Query here was successfully replaced with this one. The great thing is everything here is dynamic. So if I add here and PPT and press enter, I get Power BI and PowerPoint. If I go to the bottom and add something else, so let's go with MS Excel, I get Excel back. It loops through this list until it comes across an empty cell. Now you might be wondering, is it safe to use offset in a Lambda? Isn't it going to cause problems because offset is volatile? Well, I'm not sure. I haven't tested it in terms of performance. On this data set, it's pretty fast and it works. So the more time we have to experiment on these Lambdas and come up with solutions, the better we're going to get at using these Lambdas. Now for me, this is a super exciting development. Let me know what you think and if you had a chance to test recursive Lambdas. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give that thumbs up before you leave and also subscribe if you're not subscribed to this channel. And I'll see you in the next video.